Take crop leek and garlic of both equal quantities. Pound them well together. Take wine and bullock's gall, mix with the leek. Let it stand 9 days in the brass vessel. Well, not exactly something Snape would assign. New research shows this medieval potion might have healing powers. Hey Muggles, Julia here for DNews. So that sounds like something out of a spell book, eh? Well, actually, it's a remedy found in a 1,000-year-old Anglo Saxon book. Modern researchers found that this concoction conjured up a cure for an eye stye. That's when you get an annoying, painful bump on your eyelid from an infected hair follicle. Scientists from the University of Nottingham in England recreated the recipe using ingredients as close to medieval as possible, which was a little tricky. I mean, leek and garlic have been bred over the centuries and probably look pretty different than what the recipe called for. Wine was fairly easy. The researchers got it from a historical vineyard, and the bullock skull, parts of a cow stomach. That was pretty easy to get too. After being mixed together and left to sit for 9 days, the researchers tested the potion on scraps of mouse skin. The skin had been infected with a superbug version of MRSA. Surprisingly, it worked. It killed 90% of the bacteria, pretty much equivalent to modern-day antibiotics typically used to treat MRSA. The researchers found that it wasn't just one ingredient that killed off the bad bugs, but the combination of them. While this is rather exciting, this research isn't published yet. It will be presented at the 2015 Society for General Microbiology Conference. Other researchers tried to recreate the potion, but it didn't go so well for them. Their concoction turned into a loathsome, odorous slime, so more research is needed. As we face the rise of antibiotic-resistant superbugs like MRSA, looking into the past might be the way forward. Scientists think ancient cultures like Egyptians, Chinese, Greeks, and Nubians, and many more were purposefully making antibiotics to use in medicine thousands of years before the discovery of penicillin in 1928, which marks the dawn of the age of modern antibiotics. Sugar and honey have been used in dressing wounds for over 4,000 years, and can even be traced back to the ancient Egyptians. More recent research found that the Egyptians were onto something. Honey, which is mostly made up of sugar, kills bacteria in a kind of 1-2 punch. High sugar concentrations draw out water from bacteria, which basically kills them through dehydration. But other properties, like honey's acidity, also hamper the bacteria. This is different from modern antibiotics, which usually damage bacteria's growth processes, which bacteria is quickly able to develop a resistance to. Or maybe ancient cultures used beer to fight bad bacteria. One study published in the American Journal of Physical Anthropology suggests that ancient Nubians, a people who lived in present-day Sudan, made gold beer with antibiotic properties. The researchers looked at bones from between AD 350 and 550 and found traces of tetracycline, a type of antibiotic made from soil bacteria. The researchers think that the ancient culture used the beer to treat certain diseases, just like how ancient Egyptians and Jordanians used beer to treat gum disease. There's loads of other examples of ancient medicine proving itself in modern times, like Chinese plant used to fight malaria or mugwort used to treat herpes. Now, I'm not saying all natural remedies are effective, there are some shady shams out there, but it'll be a cool area of research to keep an eye on. Alright guys, what do you think? What ancient remedy would you want to try? Let us know down in the comments below, and while you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here every day. We've got new episodes.